2 weeks ago, we told you about the Moiliili residents who are frustrated because of some chickens that moved in, especially the rooster, which they say crows all day long and even at night. Today, some of those folks got together with the nearby elementary school to put an end to the problem, even after the city said it was going to step in to help. Nestor Garcia follows through to find out what's being done. Nestor.
Marissa, the residents of two condos, together with the Prince Kuhio Elementary School, put up the money for a professional exterminator to do the job.
Here's the recipe to catch a chicken or a rooster. You take one specialist, a handful of wire traps, sprinkle some bird feed, and add a little water, then wait. The sound of caged birds is music to at least one condo resident who told me she sometimes wakes up in the dead of night to a crowing rooster.
This is the middle of the city. Did you ever think that you had to put up with chickens?
Not that. We got used to the noise of the traffic, of the school next door. It's all our neighborhood, and also, you know, the ambulances. But the roosters, I mean, I wake up and I go like, it's time to get up. 1 o'clock, you hear the roosters. It depends. Maybe the moon comes out, a light shines on them, they wake up. They're feral chickens, and they do their things.
They laid the traps where the birds like to hang out, along the bushes on the King Street side of the school. I spotted three in this area of the campus. There are three others on the grounds of the Contessa.
As you can see, the chickens are getting used to going inside the cage because they're drawn by the food. This will be the way for the next couple of weeks until the exterminators come back, activate the doors, and the actual trapping can begin.
They were our pets at first, and then pretty soon, unfortunately, they became pests. Our sidewalks had to be cleaned more often because of their droppings. Our PE teacher was beginning to see all of these little holes being dug in the ground, and he was afraid that the children would sprain their ankles as they ran across the field.
So the school, together with a couple of condos nearby, pooled their money to pay $1,500 to get rid of the former pets.
What happens with the chickens and the roosters when they're trapped?
I'm not sure, and maybe I don't want to know.
Again, it will cost $1,500 and will hopefully take 4 weeks to do away with the roosters and their chickens. Now, as for the city, there's $80,000 in the budget for this year and next to tackle the problem island-wide. Nestor Garcia, KHON2 News.